Multithreaded rendering will optimize the rendering work by dividing it into multiple threads. This feature is indicated for users that have a CPU with more than 4 cores. Material quality will improve the depth of materials through a lightning technique called normal maps, which simulates the relief of objects. With texture quality, I didn't notice any visual changes, but this feature can increase GPU memory usage, so if your graphics card doesn't have much memory, I recommend setting texture filtering to low. Detail quality will improve the visual detail of maps by adding more objects and improving grass and vegetation. UI quality will improve the quality and visibility of the user interface, making it brighter and blurring the background when you open the armory, for example. Vignette will insert a kind of shadow in the corners of the screen, centering your focus in the center of the screen. VSync will make the FPS more stable, but this feature may increase frame time, so I recommend turning off VSync. Anti-aliasing will make the corners of objects smoother, and you will notice less aliasing on objects. Anisotropic filtering will improve the visibility of textures away from the player in the game. With improved clarity, you will notice that Valorant will be a little brighter, but this feature is not very noticeable and can reduce FPS on some computers, so I recommend that you disable improved clarity. Experimental sharpening will make the corner of the object sharper, improving visibility. Bloom is a post-processing effect that adds a glow to illuminated objects, such as weapons and agent abilities. Distortion will visually distort objects when you use the knife, for example. With cast shadow, I didn't notice any visual changes, and these were the best settings for my computer. Share in the comments below which settings were best for your computer.